And I hope not.
They didn't tell me anything, so... They're going to surprise you, they're surprised.
Thank you.
Thank you. good evening, and welcome to the class of 2023's Candlelight. The seniors ask that you please silence your cell phones. Also, we need to stand up and remain standing until the seniors come in and they are seated. And then at the very end, we are to remain seated until the very last senior has exited the building. And we're ready to go.
Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the
Hi, I'm Abby Terrio. Esteemed guests, welcome to the first of our graduations, the momentous Candlelight. Today we gather here during the culmination of our journey, as we bid farewell to the sixth chapter in our lives. In the gentle flow of Candlelight, it's easy to see why in history Candlelight has been used to represent enlightenment and knowledge. We are celebrating here. As we embark on new adventures and embrace the unknown, let the light of these candles serve as a constant reminder that there will always be light to guide us through the new chapter of our lives. We could not do this alone. This ceremony is not only to celebrate the students, but the people who got us here. First and foremost, our parents. Selflessly invested in our days of pre-K and kindergarten to the very end. You have given us support, guidance, and helping to shape the people we are today. In addition to our parents, we have our teachers consistently presenting us with challenging tasks to improve us because they saw potential. Pushing us to go beyond our comfort. In doing so, we have grown both academically and personally. Their unwavering dedication is seen in homework assignments, projects, and tests, all designed to shape us into our best assumptions. Ultimately, our teachers have gone above and beyond their duty to educate. Their commitment to our success is evident in the time and effort they have invested in designing meaningful assignments, providing guidance and support. Through their dedication, they have not only given valuable knowledge, but also nurtured our potential and set us on a path toward lifelong learning and success. And last, but not certainly not least, the coaches with their unwavering guidance and expertise. They have instilled in us the values of teamwork, discipline, and perseverance. Importance of resilience in the face of challenges. Their effect is not confined to a playing field or a world of winning and losing. Rather, guidance shown through moments of triumph and consolation during moments of defeat. It has taught us the importance of resilience, humility, and the pursuit of excellence in all aspects of life. Your dedication and patience and mentorship do not go unnoticed. Our class has left big shoes to fill and was always dedicated to raising the bar. We have secured victory in multiple homecoming events, demonstrating our unity and spirit. Furthermore, our back-to-back state championships showcase our dedication and skill that go unparalleled. As we carry these candles, we also carry with us lessons of perseverance, teamwork, and the profound impact of the support of the people here today. Let us celebrate the closing of this significant chapter with gratitude in our hearts. We stand here as a class, forever bound by the memories and experiences we have shared. As we take our next steps, may the light of these candles guide us on our journey, illuminating the path to a future filled with potential bigger than the whole sky.
Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road. And all this wave is straining us along. Just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home. So that trouble, it might drag you down. If you get lost, you can always be found. Just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your
Hi everyone, I'm Jenna Galant.
And I'm Joe Conrad.
Tonight, we will be reciting The Road Not Taken by Robert Frost. We chose this poem to encapsulate our graduating class, as we figured many of us have different roads laid out ahead. And though our futures all look very different, we are all moving forward and will be continuing our own stories. So without further ado, The Road Not Taken.
Two roads diverged in a yellow wood, and sorry I could not travel both, long I stood, and looked down one as far as I could to where it bent in the undergrowth.
Then took the other as just as fair, and having perhaps the better claim because it was grassy and wanted wear, though as for that, the passing there had worn really about the same.
And both that morning equally lay in leaves no step had trodden black. Oh, I kept the first for another day. Yet knowing how way leads on to way, I doubted if I should ever come back.
I shall be telling this with a sigh, somewhere ages and ages hence. Two roads diverged in a wood, and I took the one less traveled by, and that has made all the difference. Thank you.
You keep on walking till you find the window. If it's cold outside, show the world the warmth of your smile. But more than anything, my wish for you is that this life becomes all that you wanted to. Your dreams stay big, your worries stay small. You never but you never forget all the ones who love you in the place you left. I hope you always forgive and you never regret, and you help somebody every chance you get. Oh, you find God's grace in every mistake, and always give more than you take. But more than stay.
Remember when the streetlights came on and we had to be on the run? Remember when Elm Street came on, couldn't watch it alone? Remember every break we made at Star 69? Remember telling 88 to go back in time? Remember when they played Purple Rain to our first slow dance? Remember when we thought that first base was just holding hands?
have to flip it or I was going to tell you I was Joe Connor on, which is not true. Do you want me to use the other one, Mr. Keene? In order to be considered high honors at Dirigo High School, a student must have a cumulative average of 93 or above. It's my great privilege to introduce you tonight, our 2023 high honors students, and to bestow upon them a high honors cord. I will call up the high honors students in alphabetical order. Please remain up front to the right of the podium until all high honors students are acknowledged. I am going to start with Austin Adams. Austin Adams of Canton is the son of Travis and Becky Adams and will attend Central Maine Community College to study precision machining. Congratulations, Austin. Junbei Chen. Junbei Chen of Rumford is the daughter of Nei Hu and will attend Wesley College, currently undecided on her major. Congratulations, Junbei. Joe Conron. Joseph Conron of Canton is the son of John Conron and Christine Kerrigan and will attend the University of Arizona to study engineering. Congratulations, Joe. Jenna Gallant. Jenna Gallant of Canton is the daughter of Shane and Catherine Gallant and will attend Rensselaer Polytechnic Institute to study biomedical engineering. Congratulations, Jenna. Emma McFarland. Emma McFarland of Dixfield is the daughter of Sean and Beth McFarland and will attend Husson University to study pharmacy and health science. Congratulations, Emma. Grace Robbins. Good help's hard to find. I am so sorry, Nick. I really do appreciate you. Sometimes things just come out of my mouth when you least expect. Grace Robbins of Dixfield is the daughter of Scott and Jessica Robbins and will attend Boston University to study business administration. Grace is this year's valedictorian. Congratulations, Grace. Abigail Terrio. Abigail Terrio of Peru is the daughter of Philip and Lynn Terrio and will attend Central Maine Community College to study nursing. Abby is this year's salutatorian. Kara Woods. Kara Woods of Peru is the daughter of Craig and Angela Woods and will attend Central Maine Community College to study nursing. Congratulations, Kara. All our fans and family and friends tonight, this is the 2023 High Honors students from Dirigo High School.
I'm here to give this year's Art Award. Now, this year's student who gets this is phenomenal. They have painted every single banner this class has ever made. They're always living in the art room. Always. I have never had a lunch without this person. They even came in on a Saturday to help me paint the senior banner above. They gave up a nice Saturday. Person is not going to be going to art school. Though they would rock it and do awesome. This person is, I don't know if you guys have figured it out. Jana Gallant.
It's okay, Jenna. Just take your time. So the first time I came up, I said I was not Joe Conron, which is true. This is the second time I'm up, and I'm not Mr. Hamelin, which is also true. Unfortunately, he has a family emergency and is not able to be with us tonight. So I had the opportunity to do the music award. It was either that or direct the choir. Mr. Carvis got that gig. So I'm going to ask the music award person up first, because I need them to open this gift, because there's no explanation for this except that I'm not a music teacher. So this music award goes to Junbei Chen. And I am going to ask you to open this, and then I'm going to explain why this is the music award, because it doesn't make any sense to anybody but me. Keep going. It is an elephant. So when I was directed to get the music award, because Mr. Hamelainen was not here, I was like, don't know what to get for a music award. But I remember this. Mr. Hamelainen once said to me, Junbei Chen is the best flutist I've ever had the privilege of working with. She never forgets a lesson. She never forgets what she's supposed to be doing. She doesn't forget to practice, and she just plays marvelously. So I thought, what never forgets? An elephant. So I went out and found this hand-carved elephant so that we know that you are the wonderful musician who never forgets her music. So congratulations, Junbei.
The Science Award is given annually to a graduating senior and represents the highest honor recognized by the Science Department. The recipient of this award must reach high expectations over the course of their high school career in a variety of advanced and or upper level science classes. Most importantly, they must also demonstrate the desire to pursue scientific knowledge beyond high school. This year's Science Award winner meets these requirements. Having found success in advanced foundations, advanced biology, advanced chemistry, forensic science, environmental science, physics, and anatomy and physiology. They combine their work ethic with natural intelligence. They are diligent, wanting to understand and not just get it right. They ask questions for clarification and seek out creative ways to grasp concepts and information, often through amazing hand-drawn visuals. They are also always an integral part of the team, both in the classroom and laboratory setting, sharing their passion for learning with their peers. This year's award winner plans to continue the pursuit of scientific knowledge by majoring in biomedical engineering at Rensselaer Polytechnic Institute in Troy, New York. On behalf of the Science Department, we are proud to present the 2023 Science Award to Jana Gallant.
need to check first. Okay, so this person for the math award embodies the mathematical mind. They have an uncanny ability to dissect problems, to figure out basically how to solve them, any means necessary. I'd like to present the math award on behalf of the math department to Grace Robbins.
Good evening. This year, there was very little debate among Ms. Edwards, Mr. Conant, and myself as to who should receive our book award. The recipient this year is the quintessential student, responsible, reliable, self-directed, with a towering work ethic. I don't know for sure what path she'll take in life, possibly the United Nations, maybe the White House. Though I think she may be too humble and kind for politics these days. I only know that she elevates those around her, and nothing is beyond her grasp. It is my honor to present this award to Grace Robbins.
Each year, the English department chooses an exceptional student to receive the Dirigo High School English Award. This student reads with interest and engagement, voraciously consuming books that are assigned in class alongside books they have selected themselves. They gracefully balance speaking and listening in class discussions, and they write with clarity, creativity, and conviction. So much of English class is about ideas. When we read someone's writing, they are speaking to us, and we are listening. In an English classroom, each story shared is the catalyst for making meaning of our world and the people in it. It sparks consideration of where our ideals, our values, our experiences fit in with our peers and our communities. Through storytelling and exchanging ideas, we figure things out about the world we live in and who we are in it. This year in AP Literature, I had the pleasure of working with three exceptional students who brought it all together day after day, coming to class prepared, engaged, and ready to think critically. These three stand out because they readily choose paths that challenge them. Whether it's 40 plus pages of reading at a time, a timed writing on a poem from a very different time, or a class discussion where we share our interpretations, AP Literature requires each to bring their best self to the material and task. These students think independently, challenge one another respectfully, and embody the confidence it takes to hear a peer's brilliant idea and then add their own. They are students who deepen every conversation with their careful reading, their palpable sense of self, and their unabashed respect for the author and the craft of writing. These three students transform the idea that teaching is my job to the truth that teaching is my privilege. Thank you for pushing yourselves. Thank you for treating the literature we read together and its content with care. Thank you for all the conversation, ideas, hard work, laughs, check-ins, music recommendations, and joy you brought to our class time together. Congratulations, Grace Robbins, Joe Conran, and Junbei Chen. You're all receiving the ELA Award.
Good evening. For those of you who don't already know me, I'm Heidi Broomhall, and I am the world language teacher here at the high school. So I'm going to indulge a little bit, since for a whole lot of reasons, I rarely get to stand up here and brag about a class of 9 outstanding students who survived Spanish 4, especially since in my 3 years of having to split my time with the middle school, this means this group and I have spent the last 6 years together from the 7th grade until now. Woo, here we go, folks. I am always a mess at this time of year anyway, but it's even harder letting this particular group walk out the door. So I would like to take a few minutes of your time and theirs to congratulate our 2 accelerated juniors, Isaiah and Logan, for finishing out their Spanish careers. I want to wish Junbei the best, who arrived at Dirigo in a different academic place than her classmates and spent the last 2 years in independent study Spanish 3.5 and 4.5. I was thrilled when Abby decided to come back to Spanish after a detour through Region 9. And thanks to her accelerated independent study in Spanish 2, she jumped back into Level 4 like she had never been gone. Shout out to Joe, whose zany excuses got the class out of some assignments or earned them extra points or got them an extension. And for the time, he talked the class into performing a line dance to a Spanish country song in order to earn full corrections on a test. It will be hard to forget Austin's good humor and the best advice ever given in a Spanish class. When in doubt, snap it out. Cheers for Kelly, who perhaps is the hardest working student in our program. And to mi querida Jenna, who always tried to use her Spanish whenever we passed each other in the hallways. Te aprecio mucho, mi querida. And finally, to the one who can pull the most obscure vocabulary words from her memory bank and whose career goals to work in international diplomacy, either at the UN or the World Bank, set her apart as a world language learner, as someone who will find the pursuit of upper-level world language useful beyond high school. I am very proud to present the World Language Department Award to Grace Robbins.
Growing up, woo! So growing up, woo! I lay my bed in someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of these little things.
Wish I didn't have the answers. Wish I didn't drink all of that last verse. Wish I made it to homecoming. Got up the courage to ask her. Wish I would've gotten out of my shell. Wish I would've bought a back on that show. Wish I wouldn't worry about what other people thought. And how comfortable myself. Rooftop open. Woo! And the stars above. Woo! Moments frozen, sneaking out and falling in love. Woo! Me, you and that blue talk. Woo! We just began. Woo! All you guys dreaming. Figured out who I was. Those good old days. Somebody would've told me. Someday these will be the good old days. All the love you won't forget. And all these reckless nights you won't regret. Someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic in these good old days. While we get old, maybe we're still young. We always look back and think it was better than it was. Maybe these are the moments. Maybe I'm missing what it's about. Been scared of the future, thinking about the past. I'm missing out on how we've come so far. Ooh, I guess I'm sad. Ooh, and I ain't worried about the wrinkles around my smile. Ooh, I've got some scars. Ooh, I've been around. Ooh, I've got some pain. I've seen some things, but I'm here now. Those good old days. Oh, you don't know what you got.
Hello?
Hello?
All right, so I'm going to have my back to you while I address the senior class. So I thought I would give you the opportunity to experience what the teachers experienced during remote learning by putting a Zoom screen on my back for you to see. You'll notice it's only my name because that's what the majority of us saw all through remote learning. All right, good evening to the class of 2023, students, staff, family, townspeople, and anyone who might just have joined us because we look like a cool crowd. I had a difficult time writing this speech, not because I couldn't come up with something to say about this group of amazing individuals, because I had too much to say. I could have talked about how you dominated homecoming by coming in second your first year, and first your junior and senior year. Don't even get me started on those amazing banners. Still think we were Robson. I could talk about your back-to-back success at Spring Fling, winning both junior and senior year, and how much fun Hungry Hungry Hippo and Musical Chairs was to watch. I could talk about your success on the sports fields and in speech and debate tournaments. I could mention the names of all the senior boys who won back-to-back state championships. But I figured other speeches will probably cover those successes. I thought long and hard about different themes for this speech, and I decided on the following: acceptance, originality, and opportunities. I have been here since 2001, and I cannot think of a single graduating class that welcomed new classmates in so easily. At the start of your freshman year, this class started with 60 students. Between then and now, we saw 15 students move, transfer, or take another route to finishing high school. We saw 7 students move in or transfer into our class. And from what I saw, you treated them as if they had been with the class since the very beginning. You made sure they felt welcomed at school events, in the classroom, at your homes, and on sports fields. You opened your arms to the underclassmen, and for the past 2 years, you have modeled how they should act at school functions and events. You welcome the exchange students that have bravely left their homes. You included them in your lives inside and outside the school. You gave them cultural experiences and extended your friendship to them. As a class, you welcomed in individuals looking for a new home, and that is a special skill I hope you carry forward into your next settings. When it comes to originality, each and every one of you has been able to maintain your flair as part of the class of 2023. Even though you function as one unit when it comes to working as a team. Within that team, there are 52 individuals with different style, hopes, dreams, aspirations, and much more. You have been able to put aside your differences to make tough decisions and sometimes put the class above your own needs. Lastly, I would like to talk about opportunities. The first day we met, I encouraged you to take advantage of the opportunities that Dirigo could provide you. You not only took advantage of those opportunities, but also took hold of opportunities outside the school, and in many cases, you made your own. So at this point of the speech, we're going to do a little participation. So I am going to ask the audience to hold their applause, or else we're going to be here for a while. When I say something that applies to you, stand up or wave your hands, your choice. Totally your choice. Please stand up or raise your hand if you ever attended Region 9. Don't follow directions either. Oh, hold on. Remain standing if you attended Region 9 for 2 or more years. remain standing if you attended Region 9 for 3 or more years. Stand up if you were ever part of chorus or band at Dirigo High School.
Chorus.
Please stand up.
Oh.
Please stand up if you learned how to play a new instrument in high school. Have a seat. Please stand up if you were part of a club or an activity in high school. Remain standing if you're an officer. Have a seat. Please stand if you ever checked out a library book in high school. I was a little nervous about that one, not gonna lie. All right, have a seat. Please stand up if you've ever flown an airplane. Please stand up if you challenge yourself by taking a class outside your comfort zone. I was thinking art. All right, have a seat, please. Please stand if you were part of the speech and debate team in high school. And I should also share that someone was a national qualifier. Please stand up if you're a part of Upward Bound. Oops. Please stand up if you played a sport in high school. Remain standing if you were either a captain or co-captain. Otherwise, have a seat. Seat, please. Please stand if you held a job during high school. Have a seat. Please stand up if you took an advanced AP, dual enrollment, or college class. If we were giving out a prize for the most college classes, it would go to Joe. Have a seat, please. Please stand if you are a class officer or student council member. Should be like 8 of you. Oh. Good job. Please stand if you are an office, lunch, or classroom aide. Community service. All right, thank you. Please stand if you took a JMG class. I'm going to go with if you don't know, you didn't do it. Please stand if you took part in a club or organization outside of school. Girl Scout, Boy Scout, 4-H. Yeah, all right, we got Amber up. Please stand if you feel like. Oh, this one's good. Please stand if you feel you could ask where the bathroom is in a foreign country. Thank you very much. I was a little nervous going after you, bro. Please stand if you will be continuing your education next year. Next year. remain standing if you will attend a two-year college. Have a seat. Please stand if you are going to a four-year college. All right, so we've done the opportunities. Let's do some achievements. You're going to stand a little more. Okay. Please stand up if you earned your EMT license. Please stand if you won one state title in sports. No, just one, just one. There you go. Please stand if you won two state titles in sports. Thank you. I won't do it again, but it was next, the debate thing. You want to do it again? Okay. Please stand if you earned your CNA license. Remain standing if you are currently working because of that license. Thank you. Please stand if you received a scholarship on Sunday night. Remain standing if you received a scholarship that we aren't aware of from one of your colleges. Grant, scholarship, loan. More money coming in. All right. Thank you very much. Have a seat. Yep. Please stand if you received a classroom award in your high school career. Remain standing if you earned more than one. Oh, we got to think now. Freshman, sophomore. Okay, have a seat. Please stand if you joined the armed forces in high school. Did I miss anything big? Please stand if you scored more than 1,000 points. Please stand if you attended a chess tournament during the inaugural year of the program. All right, we're going to shift gears for 1 second, and we're going to see if your families are still paying attention. Families, please stand if you ever volunteered your house or your truck bed for homecoming. Please stand if you ever fed the kids during homecoming. Please stay standing. Please stand if you've ever taught one of these children. Please stand if you've ever coached one of these students. No, keep standing. Keep standing. Ever coached. Please stand if you ever drove one of these kids to a practice or a game. Mm-hmm. Please stand if you ever sat down and assisted one of them with their homework. All right. Please stand if you ever read to them. Any age. Please stand if you ever played ball or catch with them. Please stand if you ever gave one of them a pep talk. Please stand if you ever cleaned a scraped knee or dried a tear. Please stand if you ever helped them to learn how to drive a car. So, class of 2023, these are the people you should be thanking for being your cheerleaders, your cooks, your counselors, your drivers, your coaches, your mentors, teachers, nurses, and everything else your parents have done for the past 18, 19 years. Thank you very much. Have a seat. These are the people who encouraged, maybe begged. Applauded, pushed, watched from the sidelines, maybe not the sidelines, as you succeeded in getting to where you are today. Last but not least, a personal level. I would like to thank you for allowing me to be your advisor. Not that you really had a choice. These past 4 years might not have gone exactly how we hoped, but you made the best out of every opportunity you could. And it was a joy to watch you all work together. You will never realize what an impact you made on this school and the hole you are going to leave behind. I want you to carry a little bit of Dirigo with you into your future. So, tomorrow in the office are going to be a copy of each picture of your whole class from me. So make sure you go pick them up because I don't need that many extras. And under your chair is a gift from the high school. You are going to be missed beyond words. You can. So for those who can't see, they're all getting the same book, but it was signed by a lot of the staff. It's got a whole bunch of Dr. Seuss quotes from all of the different Dr. Seuss books. Thank you for being both the individuals you were and the class you became.
best advice. He said each day's a gift, not a given right. Leave no stone unturned, leave your fears behind, and try to take the path less traveled by. That first step you take. Today was your last day, but tomorrow was too late. Could you say goodbye to yesterday? Yeah. Would you live each moment like your last? Leave old pictures in the past. Donate every dime you had. If today was your last day. Worth the prize is always worth the fight. Every second counts, cause there's no second try. So live like you're never living twice. Don't take the free ride in your own life. If today was your last day, tomorrow was too late. Could you say goodbye to yesterday? What's worth